Hi, just a quick video on the removal and replacement of an old floppy drive, A drive, on a Korg Trinity workstation. I've had this machine for some time, but the A drive eventually gave up and made it impossible to download patches, so I ended up buying one from eBay, I think, for about £24 in English. Here's the old one I took out. What I did do is I replaced the belt, which was really stretched, and I replaced it with a piece of cycle inner tube. It did work, but the actual A drive refused to recognize the discs. It said none of them were formatted. Well, they were, but I don't know what caused that problem, but I know the drive actually worked. So I replaced it with this one, which I bought off of eBay, and it cost £24, and I was very glad to be able to repair this machine and get it back in full working spec rather than have to pay the repairers, which are over 30 miles from me and who quoted me for a minimum of 2 hours work at what was it they quoted me at, £56 an hour. So it would have come to well over £100 plus the journey time, a half a day taking it down there and then having to go and fetch it again, plus the fuel costs, plus, you know, as I say, the loss of at least half a day for travelling. So all in all, for £24, I'm very pleased to have the machine working again. The only problem was this bit of ribbon here. It didn't conform to the way the old drive went in. The actual pins are upside down on this one, but it still works beautifully well. The drive itself isn't upside down, it's just that the pin configuration is slightly different. I remember to connect the power lead this time, because the last time I tried it on the old drive, I forgot that. I couldn't get anything to work, obviously. Just be careful when you put the bottom plate back on your machine to do all the screws up. Undo them with a power driver if you have one, by all means, but make sure you do them up manually, because there's a good chance you could strip the threads and cause more problems. If you do it manually, then you've got full control over it and you won't over tighten, hopefully. And it pays to do it that way to avoid any problems. There's a lot of screws in the bottom of this machine. Right, the final stage now was to just test the thing worked. This was the acid test. I did try it with the drive with a cover off, but this was the acid test with everything put back together, because this is Sod's Law, where everything usually falls flat on its face, usually. So in with the disc, one of the floppies I've got with the sounds. There you go, it loaded up perfectly. There's all the files showing on the disk, ready to download. So there you are, it was a quick fix. It cost me £24 exactly in money. It cost me just over an hour in labour time, and I was very happy to save, well, best part of £100 anyway, it worked out at. So I'm very happy with that.